Sussex probably waved goodbye to the LV County Championship title after they managed only one batting point on the opening day of their latest game against Somerset in Hove. Put in after starting this penultimate game 22 points behind leaders Warwickshire, Ed Joyce's team knew that they had to get a good total on the board to amass some bonus points and put pressure on their opponents, who really had nothing to play for after they'd slipped to fifth place in the First Division table. Joyce and Chris Nash got off to a reasonable start with an opening stand of 31, which was ended by Steve Kirby, who produced a beauty to have Nash caught behind for a runner ball 23. There followed a rather painstaking session as Sussex, who would no doubt have heard of Warwickshire's remarkable morning in Worcester, fighting hard for every run through Joyce and Luke Wells. The rate of scoring now barely hit 2 runs per over, but that was of little concern for Sussex, who simply knew that they had to get some runs on the board. They played down their chances of winning the title after a brilliant late run, but having come so close to reaching the summit when these two sides played each other in Taunton a couple of weeks back, they must have known that they had a chance, even if it was an outside one. Joyce and Wells took their side to 83 for one by lunch, which represented a good morning for them. After the addition of just 13 more runs in the afternoon, Wells clipped a leg-side ball from Kirby to Chris Jones to go for 28, made in nearly 2 hours. That brought Murray Goodwin to the crease on the day that it was announced that he would be leaving Sussex at the end of the season after a 12-year stint in which he scored more than 24,000 runs in all formats for the county. Here, though, he made only 16. He then edged Sajid Mahmood to Marcus Truscothic at 130 for 3. Joyce was still there, and his superb run since he was named as the county's captain continued as he reached a patient half-century, which had taken him more than 3 hours to complete. He clearly set his stall out to bat for a long time. But then Alfonso Thomas rather ruined Sussex's day before tea. He yorked Matt Pryor for 17, ended Joyce's long vigil as he edged behind to reserve keeper Steve Snell after making a 182-ball 65. And then Thomas had Ben Brown taken by Truscothic's second ball to reduce the host to 179 for 6. So it was left to Michael Yardy and Steve McGoffin to try to get their side some much-needed bonus points with the bat. Steadily, they added 38 for the 7th wicket in 17 overs in a partnership which was just beginning to frustrate Somerset. Before it did, though, Abdurrahman, who'd only flown back into the country in the morning and didn't arrive at the ground until 2 p.m, had Yardy caught by Truscothic, who then claimed a 4th catch in the spinner's next over. James Anion, the man to go this time. And it was 5 catches in an innings for the Somerset captain for the second time in recent weeks, when McGoffin had a slash at Mahmood. Abdurrahman then bowled Lewis Hatchett as Sussex were all out for 221, losing their last 3 wickets without scoring a single run, and their last 5 for only 42. So Somerset had 12 overs to see out the day, with Truscothic seeing if he could match his efforts in the field with the bat now in his hands. He lost his opening partner, Aral Sapaya, in the 4th over, as he was trapped in front by McGoffin for a single, while Truscothic edged the tall Australian only for the ball to fall a fraction short of Brown behind the stumps. So the Somerset skipper was still there at the close with Jones, with Sussex now knowing that if Warwickshire reach 350 and then win their game at Worcester, then the title will be theirs. Much still depends on Somerset, who go into day 2 in Hove on 30 for 1, trailing by 191, with a slightly weakened batting lineup to come, shorn of Craig Keyswetter, Nick Compton and Joss Butler.